Henry Musasizi, the Minister of State for General Duties, tabled documents seeking parliamentary approval for the 1.316 trillion shilling supplementary expenditure that government spends without prior parliamentary approval, some of which included the request of 86.4 billion shillings to fund the construction of a convention centre in preparation for hosting of the Non-Alignment Movement Conference at Munyonyo Resort.
Retrospective approval is provided for in the law, but it doesn't mean that whatever we bring, you rubber stamp. It's up to you to make a decision.
Are we supposed to approve it? Rubber stamp it? What do you want us to do with it?
However, MPs rejected consideration of the whole supplementary schedule, accusing the Ministry of Finance of being disrespectful, arguing that the funds to Munyonyo were rejected by Parliament, but the government used the back door to give the money to Sudil.
What are we really doing here? We tell you don't do this, you go ahead and do it, and then you pass behind and you come back to us to come and sign with the same thing that we said, no, this is not our priority.
But that 3% is not a matter of waking up and buy waragi and a drink. There must be standards to it.
We leave you, you go and do your work. We come here, we sit here, we do nothing, and we just waste time here as parliament. You've made us look so useless.
Leading the protest was Fox Odoi, West Budama North East Constituency MP, wondering how the Ministry of Finance reached the realm of thwarting parliamentary resolutions.
They are soon transitioning to gods with capital G.
Like a parish model. And you can't find it, and you have funded some.
You're finding
so the issue of money, which you are saying, is we want to understand. No money to fund what's approved, and money is there to fund others. Just clarify on that one.
Legislators challenged powers of the Finance Ministry, citing Article 156 and Article 2 of the Constitution, which state that the Ministry of Finance can only spend in excess if what was appropriated is insufficient. They pointed out that funds to Munyonyo were rejected by Parliament in May 2022.
If Parliament has considered the matter and found it not a priority, it can't be a matter that arises suddenly as unseen.
Because for the one of Sudil, me, I want to strangle someone, but you have not allowed me to speak because we've not gone into. So the procedure issue I am raising, Chair, is whether the minister can begin answering questions for a presentation he has not made.
According to the Ministry of Finance, Uganda is scheduled to host the Non-Alignment Movement Summit from the 4th to the 7th of December 2023. However, there is no conference facility that can accommodate the over 3,000 delegates expected from 120 member states and the 17 observer countries.
The so-called Sudil money. Mr. Chairman, I know it is difficult to understand now, but the works have started at Munyonyo, and when we finish, you will really see the value for money and will appreciate why government made this decision.
This prompted the government to enter a joint venture agreement with Mera Investments Limited as the most feasible option for constructing and operating the convention center for hosting the Non-Aligned Movement, G77, and China summits. The Ministry of Finance revealed that the construction works will cost $50 million, about 187.931 billion shillings, but of this, the government is expected to inject $30.9 million, an equivalent to 113.895 billion shillings, and the rest is expected to be met by Sudil.
The source of funds for that supplementary, as required by the lawyers to show the source, he has to show the consistency with the existing regulations.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.